Man, Tusk is what a hero. I love this guy.
I've definitely seen it twice. I need to practice that.
Oh, they know where he's at. Limic might be in trouble here. The double impale comes through. They have the shards trying to block him off, but it's gonna be the death of him. Nana picking up first blood and gonna get the rune. Ooh, he is feeling quite good about himself here.
That was boots for someone. I think that was Mushi boots, to be exact.
Oh, Nando. Impale, they come in. Sunstrike is there. They end up finding the kill and, well, still in some more trouble. They're going to have another magic missile very shortly. Decide to turn to RR. They don't want to have to deal with the snowball that could have come out from Limic trying to outplay him, but he's only level one still, so it might not end up mattering anyways. Don't have Chronosphere, but Lucifer will be able to hold on to that mid tower as the ulti comes out for him. Now in a little bit of trouble, they drop the RP. And, well, okay. They're going to end up losing Lucifer here most likely. Does have those raindrops. They're getting set up down bottom.
They know the scan's there. Mushi.
Yeah. They had all the vision in the world. The TP's coming in. Looks like it's going to be a bit too late. And the shield not able to come offline for Lucifer. So, as you said, they knew about it. Just didn't end up really reacting. And now Ninja Boogie also going to get gone at. Does have not have level 6 yet. And they're fully diving for this one. They might have TP'd into a little bit too deep of a situation for themselves. Now Lucifer in further trouble has to pop the ulti. Is going to still take a lot of damage over time. The impale comes through. The RP is down there as well. They are just getting torn apart in jabs. Walrus punched to his death.
Coming in right now.
Mushi needs to be careful here. Does still have swap available if he wants to use it. They're all grouped up together, though. Execration, I don't know if this is where they want to be either, and they got the cold snap on Nando. The tornado comes through as well, only connects onto one. Tries to get the chrono and is going to be able to find it. Nicely played there. Invoker's still going to be alive for the moment, but trying to back out, getting all those stacks up. He is super dead, and now more of them going to fall as well. It was looking so good for a moment, but Raging Potato chasing them down, and it looks like Lucifer wants that kill onto Limic, but might end up paying for it after
Potato
the fact.
Here.
Yeah,
go
he has gone
here.
Far too deep. Oh. They're wondering, is not going to get off that time walk away. All right, time to pressure high grounds. See what they can get done. RR in the meantime takes down, or rather gets taken down by Nana.
Into the Tusk again.
Yeah, this is a big problem. Now it's a double kill buyback from the Oracle. They're still dealing the damage to the tower here. And, well, where are you guys' TPs? It's still on cooldown for Huskar for 2 more seconds. And looks like they're going to be able to get a bit more damage onto this tower. Huskar is not deciding to TP back home yet. They ended up getting the impale. It wasn't to cancel out the TP yet. If you wanted to, you could go for Spike Carapace play, but it was a little bit too late. And so the stun is there. Sunstrike through as well. They're not going to be enough damage to kill off Nando. Really, really rough. Oh, he's going to send in one Forge Spirit. Look at this guy. They don't know what to do. Bam. Well, they thought about going in for the full jump, but did not quite manage to get it. There's the impale that connects. A good amount of damage. The cold snap there as well. And we'll see if the Sunstrike is going to hit. They're trying to make it happen, but not quite there. And RR brought down low as well. The whole time that this is going on, though, you do have Lucifer taking down a lane of barracks. They have RP available if they want to use it, but the fight is breaking out over here in the middle. The Aegis is already down. They dropped the Chronosphere, only connects on the Nyx Assassin. Now the Yule Scepter lifted up. They are going to kill off Jabs, it looks like. Actually has heals going. He might be able to be okay here.
Oh,
Impale connects. Raging Potato's going to go down. Top lane still Abaddon. Staying alive is finally going to be brought down. But this is Oracle and Huskar, the last two survivors left in this one. Nana going to ghost walk away. They buy back on the Venge. They want to get into this fight. They want to take down the Huskar, and it looks like it indeed is going to happen. False Promise was used on RR. They disarm the Huskar. Going to take him down. Swap back in. Brought back down for the kill.
Yeah, and then now Raging Potato could be in trouble. They saw the...
Oh, trying to go for him. Sunstrike is there.
Got it.
Yeah, Lucifer, they turn to fight. The BKB's been popped. Nando, they're using everything thing on Jabs right now. And no, we'll be able to find Lucifer, it looks like, as well. Does have a TP scroll shortly.
Invoker is going to get a Rax here if they don't. Do they have TP? Yeah,
they'll be able to get back there. Nando, they don't have BKB on him, actually. And disarm, mana burn, pump fake. Nana again, just being a bit of a pest.
Could be bad.
Mushi, smoke broken. They got vision. They have the stun available. Turn into media onto him. Cold snap is there as well. Is going to pop it now, but maybe a little bit too late as well. They want to go on him, but haven't quite been able to. Snowball up to the top side. They catch on a ninja boogie, and they keep the rest of them out of the fight for the moment. Disruptor is down, but it's for the cost of two heroes, and Lucifer still staying strong in the midst of it. The Sunstrike finds the kill combo together with the Deafening Blast. Disarmed for the moment. Void slowed all the hell. Looks like he will be able to get the blink, the time walk away. Still in the trees. But again, it's painful moment after painful moment.
But he still has a lot of mobility items, which is good. Obviously, you need at least one before. Oh, nice swap there.
Oh, God. Long range. And yeah, Huskar does have BKB, but yeah, that's painful. Oh, no. They got another one. They pull him back in. Oh, the kinetic field is a little bit off the mark. And the Fate's Edict there is going to make Lemic a little bit more tanky. The snowball forward onto Lucifer, trying to keep his buddy alive. RR in trouble. They get the Chronosphere. It's dropped, but where's the damage? Where's the Huskar? It's not there in time. And it looks like he's just going to be able to live through it all. They lift up onto one. The RP is there. Pretty good. But it's going to be only the Aegis. And Lucifer is still alive. There's the jump back and away. Nana can reset if they want to. All grouped together, taking the damage, burning through that mana. Mushi is taking a good bit as well. And they are going to be able to be the dieback on the Huskar. Nobody has an answer for Nana. Mushi. He goes up to the high ground where he will be assaulted shortly by Raging Potato. But now the Hurricane Pike, the glimpse back in. The skewer, they're trying to kill off Mushi, which they will eventually do. But what are you going to do about Nana? This guy's gone crazy and a half as well, trying to break the TP of James. He is going to get out. But what do you do now? You don't have an answer. There's nothing left.
Chrono on cooldown. BKBs are down. Can they do anything here? Nice stun. Nice stun.
The stun through the middle of the skewer. He is going to be taken back to pretty full HP. That's a pretty good time dilation as well. But Invoker will just take it off. The power of the Yule Scepter. Another EMP. Out of mana, out of time. Raging Potato just needing to get out of there desperately, but pulled back in again. The glimpse, the time wall kept him pretty survivable. Nana's going to be pushed away. There's going to be the Ghost Walk and Raging Potato.
Oh, he just went down. They know they're there, though.
They can get him if they want. The Impale is there. Sunstrike, Static Storm, Void. Does get the False Promise and the BKB as well. He should be able to live through this, particularly with the Lifesteal going through. But Nana now, the one that's going to be scouted out. All right, Chronosphere is down. Nana went a bit too deep, but the Ghost Scepter coming out. What? He's going to be swapped away, trying to stay alive here desperately, is finally going to be pulled down and killed off. That's a big one for them. Lemic, very low, is going to die. Do they have enough to take out the rest of them? That's a big question mark here as Mushi going to be popped back in, pulled back down, maybe going to be killed off. It's a scary proposition for sure, but they do have borrowed time back up again. There's the swap again. Oh my God, he's gone so quickly. And now trying to pull him back up into the high ground with Void coming back in. This could be a big Chronosphere if they can manage to find it, but they're all split out already, and it's not going to connect. Lemic may be in trouble. Raging Potato dealing damage on a Ninja Boogie, but he's already used his ulti anyways. Mushi is going to die, but coming back in immediately is that illusion. And Lucifer now out of mana, also with his ulti already down off to the side here. It's still damage coming in from jabs. He's a heavy hitter at this point, and the Mushi illusion is going to do enough to find the kill. They take him down yet again, but Nana, the real carry, the one that's causing all the trouble in the world. Raging Potato trying to escape, and does look like he's going to be able to for a moment, but there's the jump forward, the kill, the silence is there from the Invoker, or rather from the Faceless Void, but it doesn't matter for Invoker, and GG, well played, is called. Man, Maneski are looking quite strong. Execration, maybe not so much.
Yeah, that was a nice segue into saying somebody's gonna get swapped out of side of base. It was just pretty much set up by that ward. I don't think Puck's good against Dragonite mid at all. Basically did.
Well, that's sort of what ends up happening as we do miss first blood. They take down Jab. Maybe with Rubick now, he would be punished, but they can still keep these creeps off the tower and keep Chikira off the tower, most likely. Fissure a little bit off the mark. Maybe they can pull him back to the other side. Echo Slam there as well, but the Chain Frost turnaround, and now gonna have so much regen coming in on Lucifer. They find the kill. He's gonna be regening back up. Lemic is gonna fall as well. RR going to be the only one that gets out of that. And I wanna see, it feels like really it's gonna be up to Rubick a lot to make a decent amount of these plays in this game. So bottom lane's going to be pressured in. They pop the drums now, trying to get within range, see if they can take this fight. And the Fissure just barely off the mark of the pushback. Mushi is pushing down the bottom lane while this is happening. But a battle going on inside their own forest. Can they stop them here? They're breaking it up and the silence comes out. That's going to be a dead Earthshaker. James now also going down as well. Don't know if he's going to be able to make the escape from this one. Another catch, another kill, most likely going to happen. So Execration getting punished heavily as they try to invade the woods. And while that's all happening, top lane ends up going down. They're manning up, trying to take it down. Mushi almost ends up falling there. Does he go back in? I think the answer is no. There's Lucifer standing in front of everybody, not really that afraid of what's going to happen. They pull him back in yet again. Deathpool stolen, trying to turn this one. Chainfrost going to bounce around a couple times. Good push away. Rubick able to mitigate the effects of that Chainfrost. And now Nana maybe in some more trouble. Like you said, it's happening. Mushi is going to be able to back out in a way before things go too bad. Nana is dead. And now Raging Potato trying to see if they can find anything else there. They're going to be able to back out as well. It looks like Mushi Nana finds the kill on the Lemic.
Where AM's already max slot and hook.
Keep him back. Silence there as well. Ice Path, but to no avail. Rubick is already dead, and now starting to get grouped together. James is there, gets the stun off. Macro Pyre down as well. It's not quite enough damage. They ended up breaking the Fissure coming out by virtue of that mini stun, and Lucifer just standing. That Macro Pyre doesn't even matter. They can't bring him down. They can't kill him off. Raging Potato trying to buy back desperately, and Lucifer going to get the kill on that, which means all the region in the world, and he's back up to full HP. Mushi is hitting the bottom tier 3 tower. There is no answer. There is no game. They are all undead deal dead. I mean, they can buy back, but what are you really doing here? Like, Lucifer doesn't care. He's got grease.
He just dropped his items in front of them. He didn't care. You're right.
Now, this game is by and large over. I don't even know if they, like, the biggest thing and the best thing that you can say, he's denied his bracers in front of them. The best thing that you can say about this game, right here, the only thing stopping them from going for tier threes. Ice Path, Macro Pyre, Nando, the support vengeful spirit at this point, is completely falling apart. They jump forward, they kill off the Ice Path, Macro Pyre, Nando, the support vengeful spirit at this point, a little bit longer. Denying his bracers in front of them. The best thing that you can say about this game right now for Execration is that their tier 2 towers are going to be up a little bit longer before they fall. And that's the only thing stopping them from going for tier 3s. Ice Path, Macro Pyre, Nando, the support vengeful spirit at this point, is completely falling apart. They jump forward, they kill off the Venge, most likely dead by virtue of Ninja Boogie. They keep on jumping forward, and Lucifer, hey, to dive into towers, he doesn't care either. So don't do that next time is the remedy. Okay, don't have a crap draft. All right, they go on the Necro. Can they kill him? No. Can they do anything? No. The game is looking pretty bad. Nando and Raging Potato just sharing that Chain Frost like pals. 4 dead. They're all dead. Game is over. And a good game, well played, is called. James is out of it.
Virtual Savage. Describe this game.
GG Grats. So again, for anybody that was wondering, both of these teams are qualifying for WCA.